Direct from our newsroom in Washington, in color, this is the CBS Evening News with Walter Cronkite.
Good evening. Dr. Martin Luther King, the apostle of nonviolence in the civil rights movement, has been shot to death in Memphis, Tennessee. Police have issued an all-points bulletin for a well-dressed young white man seen running from the scene. Officers also reportedly chased and fired on a radio-equipped car containing two white men. Dr. King was standing on the balcony of a second-floor hotel room tonight when, according to a companion, a shot was fired from across the street. In the friend's words, the bullet exploded in his face. Police, who have been keeping a close watch over the Nobel Peace Prize winner because of Memphis' turbulent racial situation, were on the scene almost immediately. They rushed the 39-year-old Negro leader to a hospital where he died of a bullet wound in the neck.
Sitting in the morning sun, I'll be sitting when the evening comes, watching the ships roll in, and then I'll watch them roll away again. Yeah, I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. I left my home in Georgia, headed for the Frisco Bay, 'cause I've had nothing to live for, and look like nothing's gonna come my way. So I'm just gonna sit on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Ooh, I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. Look like nothing's gonna change, everything still remains the same. What 10 people tell me to do, so I guess I'll remain the
Wednesday night movie will not be seen tonight, so that we may bring you the following color telecast of the 40th Annual Awards of the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences.
One of the highlights of Academy Awards night is the arrival of glittering stars. You've seen Sonny and Cher, this is Carol Channing, and Carl Malden, beauteous Natalie Wood. Greer Garson, an all-time favorite. Shirley Jones with husband Jack Cassidy. Rosalind Russell. Audrey Hepburn. Magnificent Raquel Welch. Paul Newman with Barbara Rush. And Sidney Poitier.
We've seen excerpts from the five films nominated for Best Picture. For the record, they are Bonnie and Clyde, a Tatira Hiller production, Warner Brothers, Seven Arts, Warren Beatty, producer. Dr. Doolittle, Appjack Productions, 20th Century Fox, Arthur P. Jacobs, producer. The Graduate, a Mike Nichols, Lawrence Terman production, Embassy, Lawrence Terman, producer. Guess Who's Coming to Dinner, Columbia, Stanley Kramer, producer. And In the Heat of the Night, the Mirisch Corporation production, United Artists, Walter Mirisch, producer. And now for the best picture. May I have the envelope, please? Thank you. The winner is In the Heat of the Night, Walter Mirisch.
See the tree, how big it's grown, but friend, it hasn't been too long, it wasn't big. I laughed at her and she got mad, the first day that she planted it was just a twig. Then the first snow came and she ran out to brush the snow away so it wouldn't die. Came running in, all excited, slipped and almost hurt herself, and I laughed till I cried. She was always young at heart, kinda dumb and kinda smart, and I loved her so. And I surprised her with a puppy, kept me up all Christmas Eve, 2 years ago. And it would sure embarrass her when I came in from working late, 'cause I would know that she'd been sitting there and crying over some sad and silly late, late show. And honey, I miss you, and I'm being good, and I'd love to be with you if only I could.
I thought I saw the house cringe as we drove up.
What you have is a simple case of pregnancy. Merry Christmas.
Ho, ho, ho. Come
room. Can we sleep here? Please? And I...
This is another fine mess you got us into.
What do you think got those Indians so upset?
Who wouldn't be upset? Telling all those poor Indians that all the gold they found was non-returnable. Quartz.
How do you like this fiendish plan? Putting those cold Budweiser so close. Hey, I can read the label on this one. Listen to this. This is the famous Budweiser beer. We know of no brand produced by any other brewer which costs so much to brew and age. Our exclusive Beechwood aging produces a taste, a smoothness, a drinkability that you'll find in no other beer at any price.
If we ever get out of this, why don't you become a radio announcer? I sure wish the cavalry would arrive.
Oh, what makes you think the cavalry's going to come and rescue us?
Rescuing us is purely accidental. Today is payday at the fort. And yonder lies Custer's last stand.
Budweiser, best reason in the world to drink beer.
Here is, from Wales, Tom Jones, and he's magnificent.
you say. You find it happen all the time.
Oh!
Olinka Barova, a new star. Olinka Barova, a new face, a new beauty as she. Remember the name, you'll not forget the woman. She has returned in our time to make two worlds meet in vengeance.
God seen some sinning, and it gave him pain. And he says, stand back, I'm going to make it rain. He says, hey, brother Noah, I'll tell you what to do. Build me a floating zoo, and take some of them
green alligators and long-neck geese, some humpty-back camels and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, don't you forget my unicorn.
The party.
Those Hollywood parties. Now, Peter Sellers invites you to the party. If you've ever been to a wilder party, you're under arrest.
I'm so delighted to see you. Because I ride up and down in my building every day in the elevator, and I see a man that says he's Johnny Carson. So it's great to see you finally.
It's not really. It is quite possible that between now and November, certain miracles can take place, and that something will happen to recess the war in Vietnam. What I'm in fact saying is that no program has come forth by anyone who is a candidate that says that we have other alternatives in this year or next year. Do you know in your political astuteness and in your little bags of secrets that there will be some profound change between now and the November elections?
I think it's going, again, being frank about it, I think it's going to be very difficult. I think that we're committed to a policy now. Which I have, some serious reservations, but we are committed to a policy in that part of the world which the administration feels is going to bring success. I believe that policy is supported by those who represent the Republicans. The views that I represent, quite frankly, I don't think are in any case are supported by anything other than a minority of the people in the United States. But the answer to your question is the administration, I think, is committed to a policy which they believe is eventually going to bring a military victory within Vietnam and thus end the war and thus be a success for the United States.
From all that I've read and heard, I know that you would disagree. Senator, thank you so much.
Can we end on a happier note?
Yeah.
Young girl, get out of my mind. My love for you is way out.
charms of a woman. You kept the secret of your just a baby in disguise.